Access granted.
Well, hello there, amazing people of YouTube, and I am back in Space Engineers. I used to love this game. So a little bit of history before I go into a little bit of talking about the game and whatnot and what mode I'm playing. So I've been playing this game for years, and well, not the last year or so. But I used to play a lot. I have a lot of videos about Space Engineers on my channel. If you go way, way, way back, like we're talking about like a year or two back, it was one of the main games that I played. But I always had problems with optimizations and shit like that. But I did like the engineering aspect of it. The part that it was like really what you call it, technical, and you have to think and whatnot. You need interior plates. Oh, I got frustrated because they are not green. But anyway. So I and also because there's a lot of mods for it. And I love modding, as you guys know. That's why I did all the WoW mods videos. But I actually stopped playing it because it was unoptimized and get old Imperial Galactical Survival, which is a really fucking crazy name for a game. It's way too long and way too complicated. But anyway. I then realized, or I didn't really read the news on Steam and all that, but it's out of early access now. And that was also one of the things I hate about the game, that it's been going in development for so long, and they still were in early access. And I have like this ideal plan that 2 years in early access is way enough. If you're more than 2 years in early access, you call this thing proof of concept or something like that. You don't call it a fleshed out game that's in early access, because early access means that it's in for the foreseeable future, will come out like I said. In my case, I think 2 years would be way generous. In the perfect world, early access games should only be in early access for like 6 months to a year maximum. But anyway, that's a whole other debate. See, like DayZ was like for many years in early access, and I also stopped playing that for that reason. But anyway, like I said, I noticed that it was out as a full release, so I tried it out. Installed it again, did the surviving space mission, or what it's called, the one where you basically have this space station here. You didn't have the little one here, and you didn't have the these things here, like the assembler and the fabricator. So, and the big ass motherfucking cargo container. You only had this one here. So I built the cargo container, the big one. There's some tubes. Got to lay some tubes, man. And repaired some stuff. And then this ship was down here. I dismantled all that because I'm about to build a platform out here so I can park my ship there. But I went up to that little asteroid over there. There was like a little mining base, grinded that down, and you got this machine here. And I think what I want to do is to take you guys to this one over here. That's a task ship mining. So we'll go over there in a second. But that's, I just wanted to tell you guys my little story with Planet Base. So yeah, I've been almost with this game from the beginning. I think it had been out for like a month or something. Not a month, like almost a year before I went back on it. Like in the beginning, before I played it for the first time, and it has come a long way. I will start to go into mods for this game and look at how mods are now, because the modding community already back then was amazing. And yeah. Oh, on another note, I built this one here, the miner drill and the extra cargo container there. But this ship, you get the standard, you get the base, you have to do some tasks around the base, like learning how to get oxygen and whatnot. And then I basically just built some stuff. But also we need some interior plates, some motor and interior plates, just to repair it. Can I take it down here? I totally forgot about no. That's a problem. Well, it's not a problem, I just have to go up here all the time. So let's take them. Let's take first interior plates. Do I have some there? Let's take 100 of those, should be enough. Oh. gravity, do your thing. There you go. It works. I don't know what happened there. So what I have done is, this is my drop zone for now. So when I go out and get resources with this one, like grinding stuff down, I put it in here. And then I have a sorter here that basically drains it. It just, there's no filter, it basically just drains everything. I don't know if we can we... Where is it? There you go. You can see here, I just have drain all on. I couldn't get the filters here to work properly for some weird reason. I think I'm doing something wrong, but I have to look into that. Because a lot of the physics and the engineering parts have changed a little bit since I played it the last time. But anyway, this is basically just like, if you imagine, this is like, okay, this is your buffer zone. This is where you prop all your shit. And then it goes up into the big one. And then the refinery and the assembler basically takes it, what it needs, out from the big container up there. What do we have here? We are making a lot of that. They can also take stuff from each other, so I don't really need to do that, but just for the sake of showing you guys it. But anyway, let's go out and have a look at that place over there. So X is to activate your spacesuit, basically, or deactivate gravity boots or iron boots, because you will, out in space, if you land on a metal surface, you will get you can basically attach yourself to the metal surface with your boots. And let's close the doors. This was a new thing, the survival kit. This is basically where you recharge your oxygen, your energy and all that, but to do that you need like an engine that produces energy, and you need like an oxygen station and an oxygen tank to store, either to produce oxygen or restore oxygen also. So right now I have I think I turned off the oxygen O2 generator, yeah. Because the tank, you can see here, there's a way enough oxygen in that one, so I'm basically just using the tank. Because if you put in ice into the cargo container in the back here, it will just automatically use all the ice for the O2 system. But I kind of just want to save it for fuel also. You press F to basically go in here, and here when you're in this mode, you hold down Alt and then you can move the camera around. V is changing modes. You also have this little bot guys that are telling you all the things that you want to know. And then you basically use like up and down, A, S, V, D, you know, to move around and whatnot. And Q and E to like rotate. But I like to do spacecraft in the third person mode. And then when I get close, I always go into first person. Like if I have to mine, I go into first person mode. So there's a mining outpost here. Oh, it's down there. Oh. So if you press G, you get your you can modify your hotbar down here, and you have different things that's on your ship basically. And I have my drill down here. So if you take like an item from here, let's say the drill, and then prop it down here, give you some suggestions to what you want that button to do. So toggle on off, toggle on, toggle off. Same with lights. You can do that with lights and all kind of stuff. There's a lot of, I get that. That's what I love about this game. There's so many things. You can also, if you go into, if you press K, you basically get like the control panel or what you would call it. You could, if you want to, let's say, save energy when you are parking the ship, or what you would call it. You could find like the thrusters and then like group them up. Oh, sorry, like here with lights. So I could like take all these lights, make a group, call them lights, save them. So we have a group up here called lights. And then if I go press G, we have go in here to groups, lights. So if I put that down here, and then you can, here you can increase rollout, you can basically blink length and whatnot. What you could do, what would be awesome, is to do like an on and off. So let's say you park the ship like I did over at my base. Then before you go out, you just press F9 once, and then all the lights turn off. Let's see if all the lights are off. Looks like... Oh, why are you acting at me? Because there's lights on the side. You will be building in no time. I know, my friend. Yeah, see, the lights down here is off. So if I press F9, the lights are back on. In a beeping fashion. Also, just need to find the thrusters. But anyway, let's go down to this and see what if they have anything. Oh, maybe I should go into first person mode here just for a bit. So I have number 3 to like turn on the drill, and then I basically just go in here and drill away. Drill a little bit here, a little bit of there, and this will automatically pick up the resources. You get the idea. So far I only built one. I'm thinking about building 2. Or building a better mining ship, to be honest, because this one is not that good as at mining. And my goal is to build a better mining ship and then just an explore ship with a load of cargo containers. But let's see if we can get down there without breaking my ship here. If you press C and X, no, C and space, that's up and down. You can see he's also giving us information over there. I may need to turn around, it looks like, because we orientated sideways. Oh! Damn it! Did I break my ear? Oh, I think I broke my drill. Oh, there's something in there. So I think I will just stay here. If you press F, you will go outside into like third person mode. Out, you will leave the cockpit. Let's go out there. I will evacuate the latest. Oh, you can see here my. Oh! The boots were activating there. Now I'm on my jets. I'm using my suit basically. If you're using your welding tool, you get information about the things that you're highlighting. So I was highlighting the drill here to see if it was broken, but it seems to be good. What we have here is like a connector, so you can take like a ship and then connect to it, and then you can transfer stuff between them. So let's see here, small container. They do have some stuff in here. Oh, it is not connected correctly. So what I always do in these places here, when I find these bases, and I remember when the big update came out for, you can see now I'm using my, I'm using the gravity in here for the base. They have like apparently have a gravity field, or what you will call it. Can you use F to activate stuff? So L to turn on lights. Ah, so it's a drilling facility. Neat. Okay, yeah, when they came out with like the planet thingy, I was playing a lot on the planets. That you started out on the planets instead of space, and I totally lost my train of thoughts now. Anyway, I will come back to it. It must not have been important. There's also a connector. Can I use it like now? No. So basically, you can take this connector here on this that ship here, and then you can connect it up there. You can transfer stuff between them. So this sounds like it has some problems. Oh, there you go. There's a thruster. Iron thruster. We need construction stuff. So I don't need to build a new, a better, what you call it, Mining ship, there's already one here. The only thing I need to do is to make this better. So what I'm thinking about doing is like... what this needs is basically it needs more conveyor... not conveyor belt. It needs more... what you call it? Cargo containers. Antenna. It's like a beacon. It's a really small drill, but it's okay. What I used to build back in the day was like really big mining ships, so they basically ate up a whole not planet, but asteroid in like almost no effort. This one here, it may be too little for me, man. This one here is more like if you want to go down here in small mining area. What I did was like back in the day, let's grind this door down here. It's like I had like one of those sizes ships here, and then I had like 6 or 7 drills, like a mass amount of drills just in one row, and then I basically just ate up everything and then sorted it out at my base if I needed it or didn't need it, if that makes any sense. And I kind of think that's the way I want to go now. So let's see what they have inside the cargo container here. Oh, my inventory is already full. That's also one thing I wish you could craft. Maybe you can later on, like a better, backpack. A bigger backpack. But maybe that could take away a little bit from the game, I don't know. Let's go in here. Let's press G. Oh, I can see they don't have any groups. So let's set up groups for the thrusters. That was the thing that I was talking about. Oh, wrong button again. We need to press K. Battery incomplete, interior light incomplete. We have some thrusters, so let's highlight all those. Make a group called thrust. Oh. There you go. Save it. Press G. Put it into my hotbar. Make it the second one. Toggle on off. Because there's no reason for it. It says now it has 7 days. So you look down in the lower right corner. 7 days standby time now that I'm not using it whatsoever. If I start to move around, you can see here that goes down. You might as well just save energy. So I always do that on my ship. I always, when I leave them, go away from them. I always have stuff like this so I can toggle on and off things that I don't use. So that should basically turn off all the thrusters. And I may also do one where I turn off the lights. Turn off the lights! So let's see, what else do we... that needs some little help. Construction. Let's take one of those. Construction components. Yoink. Ah, we need computers. And we need computers. Let's go deposit what I have in my inventory up here right now. It is a little bit... I don't know, tedious. Why the fuck will it not... Huh? What am I doing wrong? Wait, what? Have I turned that off or deactivated somehow? See, here it works. Yeah, I must have done something with it. Maybe is it broken? Where are you, my friend? There you are. No, it's cool. Oh, it's filled up. I have so much stone in it. I could. Man, I can't. Can I take it away? I don't think I can. I could do like this. And then just drop the stone. Oh, wrong button. Drop it out in space. And empty it that way. But it will take forever, man. Oh, good bot. You're really on the mic, my bot now. But you guys get the idea. See, it keeps taking it off from the back down here. So this one is almost empty. But anyway, that also, like, if you make these connectors, I need to make them at my base, because then I could just connect all the cargo pods here, or cargo containers to each other. Then I could basically just drag and drop it into my space spaceship, or into the containers I have on my spaceship. What is this though? Basic assembler. I don't need that one. I could actually deactivate that one. That must be computers, if I'm not mistaken. Whee! Gravity is nuts. That good here. That one is built. I don't think we have any thrust component. No, I think I have it on my base though. So normally what I would do now, it's basically just grind everything down here now. And I think I will go and do that. And then when I've grinded everything down, I think that will be like the next episode where I will take you guys and we will maybe start building our... Yeah, I think we will, in the next episode, we will start building our cargo ship. So for using for stuff like this. So I will see you there. If you, again, if you really, really want to see more of this, like, let me know down below. Because otherwise it would just be like a 5 or 6 episode series, and then that's it. But anyway, I'll see you all later. Have some awesome time. Go play this game. It's you really have to like be creative and think and all that, and that's healthy. See you all later. Bye bye.